So this will be my second video. Before this, I have given one more video which contains the basic concept of trigonometry. In this video, I'm going to explain about these three things: reciprocal relations, quotient relation, and square relations. What are these things we need to memorize? Even we know there is no need to memorize all these formula. On the basis of this relationship, we can explain all the things. Let's see how it is possible. Again, I'm trying to remind you the basic thing, that was sine theta is equals to p by h, cos theta is equals to b by h, tan theta is equals to p by b, cot theta is equals to b by p, sec theta is equals to b by p, and cosec theta, just put the comma sign, cosec theta is equals to h by p. We need to memorize only these things, nothing else. Now, what is reciprocal relation? First, if the value of sine theta is given, you can find out the value of cosec theta. How? Or if value of cosec theta is given, you can find out the value of sine theta. So the formula is sine theta is equals to 1 by cosec theta. For example, if you just think, it is given that sine theta is equals to 3 by 5. And you need to find out the value of cosec theta. So you directly write down cosec theta is equals to 1 by sine theta. You put the value of sine theta here, that is 1 upon 3 upon 5, that is 5 by 3 is the answer. So these are the formula we need to memorize, or you just try to understand sine theta equals to 1 by cosec theta, or you just cross multiply, cosec theta is equals to 1 by sine theta. Similarly, second formula will be cos theta is equals to 1 by sec theta, or sec theta is equals to 1 by cos theta. Tan theta is equals to 1 by cot theta, or cot theta is equals to 1 by tan theta. If one value is given, you can find out the second value by using this formula directly. Now, a few more formulas are based on it. First thing is this: sine theta into cosec theta is equals to 1. You may memorize it, or you may try to understand how it is possible. Proof. In two different methods, simple method, I can prove it. Sine theta is what? It is p by h, am I right? I think your answer must be yes. Cosec theta is equals to h by p. So h cancelled, p, p cancelled. So it will be 1. That is RHS proved. Or second method is what? Sine theta. And instead of writing cosec theta, you put the value of cosec theta, that is 1 by sine theta. Sine theta cancelled, so 1. So directly we can memorize sine theta into cosec theta is equals to 1. Fifth formula will be cos theta into sec theta is equals to how? 1. And what is the proof? Cos theta, LHS is what? Cos theta, you just directly write down cos theta. Instead of writing sec theta, you may write 1 by cos theta. So cos theta cancelled equals to 1. That is RHS proved. Or instead of writing cos theta, you may write b by h. And instead of writing sec theta, you can write h by b. Put the values. H cancelled, b cancelled. So what is the value? It is 1. So overall, this is the formula. For your verification, I'm writing all these things. You can memorize it. Sixth formula is tan theta into cot theta is equals to 1. Again, why? Because both are reciprocal of each other. how we can prove it. Tan theta, instead of writing tan theta, same thing I have written, and in the place of cot theta I'm putting the value cot theta is equals to 1 by tan theta. 10 cancelled, so it is RHS, right? Or instead of writing tan theta, you will write P by B, the basic formula, and cot theta you will write B by P. P cancelled, B cancels over 1. So we need to memorize this formula, what cos theta and its reverse, sec theta equals to 1. Product of tan theta and cot theta is equals to 1. Now, these are the relationship which are called as reciprocal relation. Which one? Sin theta is equal to 1 by cosec theta. Cosec theta is equal to 1 by sin theta. Cos theta is equal to 1 by sec theta. Sec theta is equal to 1 by cos theta. Tan theta is equal to 1 by cot theta. Cot theta is equal to 1 by tan theta. Sin theta into cosec theta is equal to 1. Tan theta into cot theta is equal to 1. Cos theta into sec theta is equal to 1. Now we are going to learn about quotient relation. What is that? Again, everything is based on the formula P by H, P by H, P by V. Quotient relation is what? We are going to see that. If we are going to divide sine theta by cos theta, the answer will be tan theta. How it is possible? Let's see. Let's just, instead of writing sine theta, we can put the value of sine theta and cos theta. What is sine theta? It is P by H. And what is cos theta? It is B by H. As I told you, you must memorize these basic formula, P by H and all. So reciprocal will be what? P by H into H by B, right? HH cancelled. Here is P by B, and P by B is the formula of 10 by 10 theta. Here is RHS. Proved, isn't it? And the second quotient relationship is cos theta upon sin theta. What is that? See, cos theta upon sin theta is equals to cot theta. How it is possible? Again, put the value and check. Verification, we are doing verification. You can write down proof. Cos theta by sin theta. What is the value of cos theta? It is B by H. And what is sin theta? It is P by H. Now we are going to solve it. Reciprocal, that is H by P. HH cancelled. Here is B by P. This is cot theta. Verified, right? Now, square relations. These are the formula we must memorize. First of all, try to understand. Instead of memorize, try to understand all the formula. Trigonometry will become very easy to understand. Next one is our square relations. What are those? I'm going to verify all these things. Anywhere, if you will see sin square theta plus cos square theta is written, you directly replace this name and write down 1. Okay, sin square theta plus cos square theta is equals to 1. I will show you how it is 1. Second relation will be 1 plus 10 square theta is equals to sec square theta, or you can write down, there are the branches also, I will explain you later. We may write 1 is equals to sec square theta minus 10 square theta. This is, from this formula we can find out this relation. Or we can write 1 minus sec square theta is equal to 10 square theta. These both came from this formula only. What I did? We need to verify this one only, and you just see 1 is here, 10 square theta went there. Wherever you will see sec square theta minus 10 square theta, directly you change this number into 1, write down 1 and give the reason because of this I am writing 1. Or if we are shifting sec square theta this side, 1 minus sec square theta is equal to 10 square theta, right? Now you all are thinking that how it is possible. I am going to prove it. First of all, let me write all the formulas, then I will explain one by one. Third one is 1 plus cot square theta is equals to cosec square theta. Again, the branches will be there. We can write 1 minus cosec square theta. This will be minus 10 square theta. Because if we are shifting 10 square theta that side, so this will be minus, and here is minus. 1 minus cosec square theta is equal to minus cot square theta. Or 1 is equal to cosec square theta minus cot square theta. Okay, fourth formula. So we need to memorize only one. From this we can understand the other parts. And the fourth one is this much is more than enough. Fourth we can not fourth one this is the branch of first formula. If sine square theta plus cos square theta is equals to 1, we may write that sine square theta is equal to 1 minus cos square theta. See, it is shifted there. Or for cos square theta, we may write 1 minus sine square theta. That's it. So we are going to cross check these formula, basic formula. How we can say that sine square theta plus cos square theta is equals to 1. First of all, we have taken LHS, sine square theta plus cos square theta. As we know, sine theta is what? P by H, put the square sign, and cos is B by H, put the square sign. What happened? It is P square, H square, plus B square, H square. What is the denominator? LCM of both the numbers is H square, and here is P square, B square. And with the help of Pythagoras theorem, we knew that perpendicular square plus base square is hypotenuse square. So both the numbers are same. That's why it is proved. Sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Proved. Right? Okay, now second, we need to prove that 1 plus 10 square theta is equal to 6 square theta, and which is 1 plus 10 square theta. 1 plus 10 means what? 10 theta is P square, P upon B, so this will be P square plus B square. What is the LCM for both the number? It is B square. B square plus P square. B square divided by 1 is B square, and that is multiplied by 1 is B square. B square divided by B square is 1. 1 into P square is P square. So here is B square plus P square. Again, by using Pythagoras theorem, what is that? It is H square by B square. And we knew that H by B is formula of what? It is formula of sec square theta. Sec theta, and here is the square sign. Proved. If you will understand only these formula, it is more than enough to score good marks, not in only in standard 9, for standard 8, for standard 10, for board exam also. Now the third one is 1 plus cot square theta is equals to cosec square theta. LHS 1 plus cot square theta. 1 plus cot is what? B by P. It is P. B square by P square. So what is LCM? This will be P square. P square plus P square. I hope you all knew addition of fractional number. If any doubt, please write in comment section so that I can explain you separately on other sums, how to do the fractional sums for junior students. But those who are about to appear in board exam after 1.5 years, they must know the fractional addition, because these are the part of junior classes. That's why I'm not explaining in detail the fractional addition. H by P is formula of cosec theta. That's why it is cosec square theta. Proved. That's all. Thank you. After this video, I will give you the sums based on all these formula by using ML Agarwal or any other book, RSAGWAR. Thank you.